Illness means end or is danger just slow? I do not trust.
What the fuck is happening?
Well, it doesn't sound like the call was no big deal. It sounds like it was important to you.
Sophie's alive! Did I actually manage to rewind time?
Mac, are you okay? It kind of seems like you're on drugs.
Huh? Oh. No, I'm just really happy you're here with me and your mom.
So, drugs then?
Sorry, what were we talking about? Somebody mentioned a phone call?
Yes. I was shocked too. I didn't know people still answered their phones.
Funny, Mom. And yeah, it wasn't a big deal. It was just from the publisher.
Right! Your book! The secret book!
I'm so proud of my girl. Publishing is always such a difficult endeavor.
Thanks, Mom.
Is no one going to take our order?
It's been, like, a few minutes. Have you ever had a food service job? Like, ever?
I can go ask what the holdup is, Yasmin. No sweat.
See? That is so thoughtful of you, Maxine. No need. A whole place could use a facelift, to be honest.
Come on, Yasmin. You don't have anywhere else to be. I need to ask Sophie about... God, where do I even start? What is that?
Oh shit. Dude, your nose.
It's fine. Just a nosebleed. Back in a sec.
I'm glad we did this.
This?
This lunch.
I do it every weekend.
I know. It's nice. Did you do any campus activities when you were in school?
You know, they can entertain each other. They've had years of practice. I still can't believe Sophie is here. Alive. Having lunch with Yasmin as if everything is normal. As if I didn't see her die 2 days ago. In case this does all go sideways, it was supposed to be a candid.
You'll never catch me alive.
Oh, Safia, come now.
I swear, one day I'll get a candid of Safi. They can entertain each other. They've had years of practice. Hey, so...
Come on, Mom. I'm supposed to see through your invulnerable mom mask as I age. I like that you took drugs.
Safia, Maxine is here. She's my employee.
What? You can have lunch with your employee, but you can't tell her about all the drugs you used to do?
Legally? Yes.
What crazy system is running this country? Come on, Mom. I'm supposed to see through your invulnerable mom mask as I age. I like that you took drugs.
Safia, Maxine is here. She's my employee.
What? You can have lunch with your employee, but you can't...
I guess that prankster hasn't been back. Bet Amanda's glad. Where's that sound coming from? How is Sophie posting right now? isn't Krampus canceled? Is all of this for that Krampus party? Who's performing?
It's for the Krampus roast.
Oh man, is this your first time? Yeah, Krampus on campus is,
interesting.
Yeah, that.
Look forward to seeing you there.
Maybe I can find the source of that humming if I look around. December 6th. So, it's the same day here. I didn't go back in time. Something else is happening. This diamond also has strong feelings about this Lucas. Nice to see this place gearing up for Christmas. Aw, this truly fills me with the holiday spirit. Wherever I am, looks like beer still exists. Unfortunate. Wow, these really are the worst lines I've seen. Guess that prankster hasn't been back. Bet Amanda's glad. They can entertain each other. They've had years of practice. Right, of course. There's a snapping turtle, so there's an Amanda.
Hey, stranger. How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing good. Normal.
Cool. Convincing. I shot you a couple texts. I don't know if you saw them.
Remind me what we decided on last time we talked. My brain is sort of leaking out of my ears.
That time of year, huh? A couple nights ago, you asked me if I wanted to hang. I said yes. Therefore, we decided that we would, in the near future, you know, hang. Ringing any bells?
Yes. Loud and clear.
I should get back to work. Take it easy, eh?
Okay, I still talked to Amanda 2 days ago. So far, everything here seems basically the same, except I was hoping my nosebleed days were behind me. It feels connected to that humming and whatever caused it.
Holy shit.
Now where are the 12-year-olds going to do parkour?
Hopefully somewhere with less tents.
Gender-neutral bathrooms. We love to see it. Yup, this is definitely the source of the hum and my nosebleed. Let's poke it with a stick. Source of the humming, but what is it? Holy shit. I'm back, aren't I? In Dead World, this is so fucking crazy.
I think it's sad and scary.
Oh shit, this is the Amanda I talked to this morning?
Max, you're here.
I'm here. Surprise.
You good?
I'm okay. You really cheered me up earlier.
Happy to lend out my comedic stylings to girls in need.
Thanks.
Are you here for...
We already talked in her office. She seems to be doing, you know, bad.
God knows. I offered her free coffee for as long as she wants it. I gotta get back to it. Don't forget I'm here for you, okay?
Thanks, Amanda. Oh no, I hope Amanda didn't spend all her soup energy on cooking for me. Another Polaroid from our mystery photographer.
No, Tony, I love it. I do. It's as thoughtful as ever. No, no buts. Only, I know you. If you send me a gift, it means you won't be coming this year either. Krampus isn't unsettling, it's fun. But honestly, I wanted you to finally meet Safi and Max. You'd love them. Right, next year for sure. And thank you again for the gift, Tony. I mean it. Love you back, babe.
Whoa. Am I hearing stuff from that other world? I didn't see Moses in the snapping turtle, though. This makes no sense.
I hate that they canceled Krampus for one dead student.
Jesus Christ, bro.
I don't mean it in an insensitive way. Just death rates on college campuses aren't zero. People die all the time.
Do people get shot all the time?
I guess not.
Canceled the Christmas party. I guess that makes sense.
Oh, hi, Miss Caulfield. I'm sorry for your loss.
Huh?
You were close to Safi, right?
Oh, yeah. Thanks. I appreciate it. No Christmas decorations on this side. Another Yasmin. OG Yasmin? She's so strong. I'd be a total mess in her shoes. If I can't get on here, I will face God and walk backwards into hell. Hang in there, Max. It's gonna be okay. Hi, Yasmin.
Oh, Maxine. You're here. I'd invite you to sit down, but...
I understand. I didn't expect to see you here.
When we spoke this morning, I wasn't planning on coming. But I couldn't help habit. Safi and I used to have lunch here every week. Terrible food. But it's close. Anyhow, take care. I'm sorry, Maxine. I'm all tapped out.
Amanda has been really great about all this. Or this Amanda, anyway. That's the way back across. That's the way back across.
Gender neutral bathrooms.
Cross back and love to see it. That's good to know. Safi and Yasmin are probably wondering where I am. I should get back to them. These really are the worst lines I've seen.
Honestly, Safiya, I wish you'd have told me sooner. I was getting around to it.
All clear? We don't need to get you a blood transfusion?
Oh, I'm golden. Probably just the weather, you know?
Oh, did the forecast call for massive nosebleeds?
Duty calls. Send me the bill for the windshield, please, Safiya.
Windshield?
Another piece of shit pie. Someone... Hold on, it's easier if I just show you.
Jesus. Fuck, Safi. Is that your car?
Charming, right? Found it this morning.
You don't think it's some sort of a threat?
From who? Vegans?
Stop eating burgers, or this is about to be you.
This is gonna sound bananas, but I feel like I've met this cow.
You have. It's from right over there. Whatever, I gotta meet the tow truck.
Wait, hold on. The broken horn. It looks like there was something written on it.
Max. You know I adore you, but read the room, bud. I'm not really in the mood to stare at photos of my fucked up car all day.
Yeah, sorry.
It's okay, Rocky. She's gone. Oh, tell me my proposal was shitty, Isabel. That would be a bald-faced lie, right? I challenge you. I challenge anyone on this campus to devise a better pitch. Impossible. Who in this day and age would be against a four-day work week? Dr. Yasmin Fayyad, it turns out. The same school president gracing the covers of magazines as the new face of higher ed? The only thing more surprising than her rejection was the speed at which it came. I really thought things would be different under her leadership. Or fool I. She has time for lunch with her daughter once a week, and I can't have one Friday for my son's soccer games? I'm right there with you. I'd love to be able to make my Greek group with any sort of regularity. When she...
I guess that prankster hasn't been back. Bet Amanda's glad.
She isn't the only one with a family. Neither...
Hold up. Safi's alive in this world. Her car probably didn't get trashed in the other, right?
The more I think about it, the more I realize how...
This is definitely where the skull used to be.
Hey, Amanda. I have kind of a weird question.
Do you ever have non-weird questions?
Occasionally. On a leap year.
The whole year or just February 29th?
Now who's asking weird questions?
All right, hit me then. What's the question?
Have you had any skulls go missing lately?
Wow. That's an extremely specific question. And I can't believe the answer is yes. Our only skull, in fact. I'm dying to know why you ask.
Because it somehow ended up in Sophie's windshield.
Huh. Wait, what the fuck? Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm trying to unravel the mystery.
Jesus. A skull? I mean, have they never heard of a brick?
When did you notice your cow got rustled?
Literally just this morning, before I clocked in. It had to be sometime last night.
Did you see anything suspicious?
I mean, the Abraxas kids are perpetually suspicious. They took up like 6 tables last night. Maybe one of them saw something. Hell, maybe one of them stole it.
Thanks. I appreciate the info.
Anytime, Nancy Drew.
Look forward to seeing you there. Look forward to seeing you there.
What a calamity. This truly fills me with the holiday spirit. Nothing is what it seems. Nice to see this place gearing up for Christmas. So why don't you come over to my side?
It's December in Vermont. I told you it can't be inside. That's a safe zone.
Taking the bathroom key was like a really good idea.
Did you see how many drinks he... Oh, hey. Don't mind us.
What are they planning to do with the bathroom key?
Hey, do you have the bathroom key?
Yeah?
Could I grab that from you?
We're using it. We'll put it back when we're done.
You're using it?
Yup.
They are definitely up to something with that key. Not that they're gonna talk about it with me standing here. What are they planning to do with the bathroom key? If only I could get my hands on that cow skull.
I should use my power to look in on them. From Dead World.
Hey, Amanda. Any chance you've seen your bathroom key?
Uh-oh. Are you a DEFCON 1 or DEFCON 5?
DEFCON 5.
Sounds like you can hold it then. I'm sure it'll turn up in a sec.
Wait, no, I always forget that 5 is the good one. It's bad, I think.
Maybe take a look around. Sometimes folks just forget to return it.
The skull's missing here, but maybe the turtle in Dead World still has one? If I could look at that skull up close, I could learn something. Gender-neutral bathrooms. We love to see it. If only I could get my hands on... My gut tells me it's not good news. Because why would it be? How could Vin mix me up with Sophie? Oofa doofa, that's gonna take some getting used to.
And I
Whatever happened with Visionary Ventures? You applied, right?
I sort of got the job already.
Carla, that's... Wait, are you really considering taking the job?
Safi came to visit Moses in our lab all the time. She'd...
There she is, safe and sound. Fuck, size does matter. I'm going to have to find a way to get up there. I'm pretty sure I just saw a stepladder. Where was that? No Christmas decorations on this side.
Isn't there a stepladder around here somewhere?
I know I saw a stepladder. My memory's not that bad, so where is it? She's so strong. I'd be a total mess in her shoes.
Thank you.
Sheesh. Stepladders in the other world. Finally, a chance to live out my lifelong dream of being a tall girl.
Look forward to seeing you there.
Now, dead cow, let's see what secrets you're hiding. Is that a signature? Ugh, this is so stylized, I can barely read it. Lucas Colmenero. Lucas Colmenero. Oh, shit. Did Lucas throw this through her window? That seems even less likely than the Abraxas kids. Maybe they were in it together? This doesn't make any sense. Fuck, I need to think. What is going on? What if it's not just a prank? What if this Sophie is in danger too? I just got her back. At least I know where to start. Lucas Colmenero and the Abraxas Society. Find the Skull Rustler. Save Sophie, hopefully. And my best leads are Lucas Colmenero and the Abraxas Society. Vin's the head honcho of Abraxas. I should cross over and see if he's around. Maybe I should do a little digging into Gwyn Hunter, too. She was acting pretty odd earlier. I should cross over and start asking questions. Whoever fucked with Sophie's car isn't just gonna out themselves. Whoever messed with Sophie's car is in the other timeline. I can probably find Gwen in her office, and I think Lucas has a habit of working over by the cafe.
Going to the Nationals. Your grandfather would have been proud, Robbie. Of course I'm coming. What?
I've never seen Lucas look this happy. I wonder who he's talking to. Gwen was acting really weird the other day. Wow. Jeez, Lucas looks exhausted. Too bad.
Max. Sorry.
Busy. Need something?
Actually, I...
Catherine. I've been waiting for an hour. No, just put Robbie on.
Oh, sure. I'm only the boy's father. Who fucking cares, right? How can you say...
Whoa. Adds a whole new meaning to nuclear family. If Lucas has it out for Safi, there might be something incriminating in that case. Is that an email? Dated December 5th. That's when Safi's car was vandalized. I need to get in that briefcase. Instant lock opening powers would be great. In the meantime, I have to find that key.
Can you give me a second? Surely another minute and a half isn't going to taint the building with my presence.
Just leave everything behind, Professor. You won't need any university materials.
Yeah, but I do need my car keys if you want me to leave the campus, don't I? Think.
You're not to return to Caledon property before the hearing, under penalty of law.
I know how this works. You don't need to read me my rights.
Just doing my job, Professor.
That'll go over great in Nuremberg. This is crazy. This is fucking crazy. I told Yasmin already that none of it's true. She knows it's fucking bullshit.
Wow.
This is all
I
just
guess
some
something
kind of crazy
screwy
mix-up
is going
thing.
Down here, too. But at least. Yeesh. I wonder what that was about. I need to start somewhere. Lucas or Gwen? This looks like one hell of an art final. I should check it out. Pretty sure you need a time machine to even find a phone booth now. What do I want to say to the future? There's so much more to your life than just the past. It's hard, but try to move on. I know sometimes it feels like we're chasing skies, but you. I didn't know a phone booth could feel like a personal attack. Do I have a message from the past?
What he's doing is wrong. It always felt like it was, but now I know it's true. I was starting to think my writing just wasn't good enough. How fucked is that? But she stood up for me. Nobody else has ever done that. Ever. So you know what? Fuck that guy. I won't stop writing because he's uncomfortable. That's my message to the future.
Wow. Whatever he was talking about, I hope it worked out.
Alexa, you cool? You look a mess.
Oh, yeah. I'm fine. Just waiting on Lucas Colmenero to grade my final.
Okay, but we turned them in.
Gwen left so much behind. They better let her. So this Gwen just got escorted out by security. While Dead World Gwen is having hushed phone calls about the police and trying to break into locked bookcases. Time to snoop like I've never snooped before. Gwen's wife, Claudia, I think. I met her at a faculty event last month. Gwen fucking adores her. With the way they hustled Gwen out, I don't think these students are getting their grades anytime soon. Whoa, Reggie got an A-. Doesn't seem like the type to be happy with a B. You reap what you sow, Loretta. Oh, you're other Loretta, aren't you? Oh well.
You would never do what, Gwen? What is this about? Gwen canceled her weekly meetings with Safi? Why? Oh my god, an answering machine. As I live and breathe. Almost a full cup of coffee. Gwen must have just sat down to drink it. Going to read this, I swear. If I ever have time for pleasure reading again. This thing looks older than Caladon. If Safi was an undergrad, this reading must have been at least, what, 4 years ago? Gwen is guilty of plant neglect. Although, I can't really blame her, considering the week we've all had. Drink up, buddy. sexy woman. This is the book I got for Gwen. Wait, what's sticking out from between the pages? Why would Sophie have started acting off on Friday? Something must have happened. Gwen is asking questions about Sophie's death. These emails are from way back, like before Sophie knew she wanted to be a poet. I knew Gwen mentored Sophie, but I didn't realize she was this involved. Looks like Gwen's a popular girl.
Dr. Hunter, I appreciate your condolences. You know I do, but I'd prefer if you didn't contact me for a few days. There's a few things I need to get in order. Whatever the case, I'll see you at the staff meeting. You should get a call from Vin later today.
Hi, Professor Hunter. This is Vin Law from Dr. Fye's office. I'm just calling to confirm an all-hands staff meeting this afternoon in the second floor lounge in the administration building. Attendance is, unfortunately, mandatory. Gwen, I hope you didn't. I'm not sure if you should. I don't know. Just, I wouldn't blame yourself.
Why would Safi have started acting off on Friday? Something must have happened. Live fast, eat ass. Wise words, whatever they mean. It's like a bumper sticker evolved into a bookend. Fiction, nonfiction, poetry, plays, bunch of scenes. Is there anything Gwen doesn't read? If I could see Gwen's schedule, I could find out what was so eventful about last Friday. Between Gwen and me, I bet we've road-tripped most of the country. Caked-up Mothman, goated with the sauce. God, why didn't I trade travel stories with Gwen before all this? That must have been some call with Maria on Friday. Gwen even planned out a time to follow up. Alright, Hacker Max, let's go. Search sent to Maria. Enter. Wait, this is Safi's publisher. Gwen got Safi's book canceled? These emails are from way back. Like, before Sophie knew she wanted to be a poet. I knew Gwen mentored Sophie, but I didn't realize she was this involved. I thought Gwen helped Sophie set this all up in the first place. Why would she? No, this all has to add up. Somehow. I had decided I would hitchhike across the country. If I still wanted to die when I got to the Pacific, then I could do it peacefully. Hell of an opening line, Gwen. Gwen's wife, Claudia, I think. I met her at a faculty event last month. With the way they hustled Gwen out, I don't think these students are getting their grades anytime soon. Lucas tends to work over by the cafe. Lucas is usually in the cafe at this time. two Lucases and two briefcases means two keys. Two Lucases and two briefcases means two keys.
Robbie, I gotta split. Uh-huh. I love you too, buddy.
Weird. This yeah. Lucas seems to be on great terms with his family.
Hey. Bye.
Lucas.
Max. Can't imagine it would be much fun to assassinate my character without an audience.
I wasn't going to stand by while you used Sophie to pump yourself up.
Wow. I never had a chance with you, did I? Not with Sophie in your ear.
She never really mentioned you.
I find that hard to believe.
That's a lot of books.
A lot of my book. Signed copies for the Burlington Book Expo. They invited me to deliver the keynote this year. Have you seen the standee they put up of me?
It's hard to miss.
Yeah. That ought to put butts in the seats, huh?
Here's hoping.
The standards for the expo really declined over the years. We've had a lot of mediocre
Yikes.
Visitors.
This dude can
it's
talk.
It's a shame.
How am I going to get that key?
Years and years and years, people still love the characters.
Oh, crap. I forgot. What time is it? I have to go give something to Moses, before his class. Good luck with the book expo.
I bet Lucas would really hate if something happened to this.
Now, what can I use to do some permanent damage?
It's an excellent cover, isn't it?
Guess that explains why his signature was on the thing. What's the deal with the skull?
Ah, you haven't read it, I see. The symbolism is clever, but not lofty.
Right.
They've got the original skull up in the Snapping Turtle, you know. Had my book launch party there.
Oh, yeah?
You can have that copy if you want. It's already signed.
The infamous cow skull. I feel like it's haunting me. If Lucas really is somehow involved, this might come in handy. That would sure leave a mark on anything made of, say, cardboard. Dare I channel my inner Chloe? Lucas is trying to get some work done. Maybe some loud music will throw off his groove. Now, how exactly do I want to get under Lucas's skin? The classics are classics for a reason. Oh my goodness! Who would do a thing like this? Someone should tell Lucas right away.
She returns. I take it you've delivered your something to Moses?
My something? Right, my something. Yep, something delivered. So, not to be the bearer of bad news, but somebody drew horns and a tail on your book expo standee.
Are you serious? I just put that... Come on!
Some people just have no respect for other people's property.
Come on, stupid marker. Absolutely disrespectful.
Huh. The devil really is in the details.
Damn it! It'll take too long to get another one.
I should talk to Lucas about the other night. time to reveal your juicy secrets. All right, Lucas. Let's see if you're the one who smashed Sophie's windshield. Lucas was with his agent last night, not the snapping turtle. He couldn't have vandalized Sophie's car. So, who did? No point in looking through Lucas's stuff now, satisfying though it is. So this is how the literati spend their free time. Yeah, not you, Lucas. Seriously. Guess this Lucas didn't get a chance to put this up yet. Lucas was in AA? Good for him. Did Lucas go to a gun range? Does Lucas have a gun? That damn cow skull again. Who threw this fucking thing? His agent tells him where to park, but what does Lucas Colmenero do? Park where he wants anyway. Sophie? Is Lucas really trying to file a restraining order against Sophie? Does she know about this? I'd better show her.
Max? What are you...
Lucas, this isn't...
You can't tell her.
What?
You can't send Sophie that photo. Let me explain. Please. Catherine, my ex-wife, she called last night, mad as hell, because Robbie, our son, was repeating back to her things I supposedly told him. But I never. I mean, I could never. The shit Robbie says I told him, it makes me sick to think about.
Maybe he was making it up, acting out for attention.
No. No. Even if Robbie was the type, this shit, I mean, where would a kid even get ideas like that? He told her, I said he was the reason for the divorce. And somehow that was the least fucked up thing I'm purported to have said.
This still doesn't explain the restraining order.
I wasn't even there that night, Max. But someone said those things to my son.
And you think it was Safi?
Listen, Safi once threatened to turn Robbie against me. I know she's capable of it.
Wait, why would Robbie trust Safi? Does he even know her?
She used to babysit for us, believe it or not. Robbie adored her.
And none of this has anything to do with what happened to Safi's car?
Something happened to her car?
Never mind. Forget it.
Look, I know she's your friend. I know you have no reason to believe me over her, but just give me a chance to get this shit in order first, without her interfering. I just want to make sure my boy never has to hear anything like that again.
This could all be a lie. One big smear campaign against Safi. But, oh, what if it's not? Okay, I deleted it. This is between you and her. None of my beeswax.
Thank you. If I can't find any evidence to back this up, I don't even know. At least I have time to look.
I think I've wrung all I can out of Lucas today.
I love this. It's like a confessional without all the obligations.
Paper on the ground. But who's Dookie?
Hi, Mama. Can you hear me okay? No, I'm just turning in some end of semester paperwork. Final grades for my Astronomy 101 students. And since I'm here, I might pick up some other forms for leaving grad school to take a job offer. Because I'm tired of school. I love astronomy, you know that. But I'd be an astronomy consultant at this place called Visionary Ventures. They supply talent to aerospace companies. And I wouldn't have to worry about money anymore. I could repay my student loans in no time. No, see, I'd be using my degree. I'd get to help people who make satellites and rockets. That's not fair. Oh, and thanks for congratulating me on the prestigious and well-paying job offer. I know, and I'd miss grad school.
Is that a therapist's business card? I'll bet some folks on the other side could use that. This must belong to someone flashy and forgetful and cold. I was literally just in there comforting Yasmin. But this Yasmin doesn't need comforting.
Thank you.
affecting my brain. No, no, no. Don't tell them that. No. Listen. Can you stall the board? Stall them. I'll be there as soon as I can. Absolutely I am. No, no. Well, yes, I should be taken off because my fucking child is dead, but I don't think that's an option.
This is nice and all, but there's an actual barista just next door. I think we all feel a bit busted sometimes. Those look like they should be in a file folder somewhere. Jeez, somebody robbed an airport lounge. Pick a card, any card, or whatever. Looks like this Vin is taking a break.
Fucking shit. Oh, Max, it's just you. Huh?
What can I do you for?
Are you pouring whiskey into your coffee?
Yes.
Any particular reason why?
World is a fuck, etc., etc. Join me.
How many of those do you have?
Ooh, just don't check the recycling.
Is this about Safi?
Safi, Safi, Safi. Everything is about Safi nowadays. This isn't about Safi, Max. This is about you and me.
Right.
Come on. Illicit day drinking with your coworkers is sexy. Be sexy, Max.
Far be it for me to pass up an opportunity to accrue more sexy points.
Measuring sexiness with imaginary points. Not sexy.
Minus 5 sexy points to me, then. Shouldn't we be hanging out on the train tracks? That's where all the kids drank in high school.
You're from the Pacific Northwest, aren't you? What's that like?
A little damp, occasionally torrential.
What did you do when you weren't drinking on the train tracks?
Took pictures, mostly.
And?
Swear, I'm not that interested.
I don't believe you. I like you, Max Caulfield. You feel haunted.
What?
Don't worry, it's good. Haunted people are interesting.
Maybe on TV. In real life, haunted people have to live inside their haunted brains.
Yeah. They do.
I actually really needed that. Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Sharing is caring.
What do they mean?
It's called a three-card pull. This one represents my past, the magician. It means I'm exceptionally talented, though you already knew that about me. My present, the Nine of Wands. Upside down like that, it means I'm exhausted, feeling vulnerable, and, well, guilty as charged. And my future, the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, aka the fuck around and find out card. I think I'm about to find out.
Foreboding.
Fear of the future. It's the spice of life, Max.
In my experience, we tend to cause the exact thing we're trying to avoid.
Where were you last week?
See it with my own eyes.
See what? You...
That's the fourth bottle I've seen our fearless leader open this afternoon. Is he trying to act all grief-stricken because his boss's kid died?
I'm going to call you Pauline. Have you been watered recently, Pauline?
Everyone knows Vin.
I want to be a bust. How does one become a bust?
How's it hanging, Pauline? I don't think this is what the artist intended. Back to normal.
The undergrads are restless. Cozy. And not even a thank you? Rude. dignity restored. Good luck, cramming students. How's it hanging, Pauline? It's like her eyes follow you wherever you go. Hey, Pauline. Do you ever think about dying? Looks like nobody felt like building a fire today. Looks like this Vin is taking a break. Aw, poor little guy. What happened to you?
Please, don't touch that. It was a gift.
Those look like they should be in a file folder somewhere. Jeez,
somebody robbed an airport lounge. I think we all feel a bit busted sometimes. I wonder if Sophie's book will make it in here once it's published. Thank you.
By the way, did you get your ticket to the Burlington Book Expo yet?
No. When is it again? Shiloh, it's soon.
Now, if I were a bovine vandal, where would I... There's Vin. If it was Abraxas that stole the cow skull, they might have done it on Vin's orders.